Hello friends, my name is Wasim and I welcome you all to this channel Bank for You. So friends, in this video I will be discussing a different kind of row arrangement question which was asked in SBI CLERK MAINS 2019 exam. So this is a memory based question which I have taken so that you can guess what sort of questions you may get in the upcoming SBI CLERK MAINS exam. Okay, so friends, once you come across the questions, try to solve the question by yourself and continue watching the video. So without wasting much time, let's go ahead. So here is the question. So take a screenshot of this question and try to solve it. Right? Now I just feel that you have solved this question. Now let's check out how to deal with this kind of question, because the size of the question is quite high, but then it is not that tough as much you are going to think. So that is why I can certainly say that this is not that tough. Okay? Alright. So as you can see, the first thing which is given here is there are three rows. That is row 1, row 2 and row 3, such that row 2 is the north of row 3 and row 1 is the north of row 2. So see here, there are 3 rows, that is row 1, row 2 and row 3. So in that way, that row 2 is in the north of row 3. For example, here is the row 3, so above row 3, so because we know the signs here, that is, the directions NEWS. Okay, so this row's north is this way, right? So this row's north will be row 2 and row 1 is in the north of row 2. So row 2's north is this, so row 1 will be in here. Okay, so this is row 1, row 2 and row 3. We have to take it in that way. That is nothing but, so row 1 is above, row 2 is afterwards and row 3 is later on. Okay. As you can see, the first information is there are 4 persons sitting in row 1. So in row 1, 4 persons are sitting. And 8 persons are sitting in row 2. So there are 8 persons are sitting in row 2. And 4 persons are sitting in row 3. So totally 4 persons are sitting in row 3. Okay. The next one is person sitting in the row 3 faces north. So this is row 1, row 2 and row 3. So whoever is going to sit in row 3 are going to face towards north direction. So these are the 4 people who are going to face north direction. Okay. Person sitting in row 1 faces south. So person sitting in row 1, this is row 1. So these people will be facing towards south direction. Okay. First 4 persons from west to east. So west to east means from this way to this way. That is this way to this way, faces north. Okay. First 4 people are going to face north in row 2. Okay. In row 2. So here is the row 2. So first 4 persons from west. This is the west. So from west to east, 4 persons will be facing north. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. And last 4 persons sitting from west to east in row 2 faces south. So the remaining 4 persons in this row are going to face south direction. Okay. So these are the 4 people who are going to face south direction. Okay. So this is row 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 persons are facing north. 1, 2, 3, 4 people are facing towards south direction. Okay. The next one is all the persons sitting in row 1 and row 3 are facing the person sitting in row 2. So see here, it's a note given. So whoever is going to sit in row 1 and row 3, those persons are going to face the people who are in row 2. So we know the people who are sitting in row 1 are going to face south direction and they will be facing towards, they should be absolutely opposite to row 2 people. So therefore, I can certainly say that those 4 people will be here because they are going to face this direction. Okay. So 4 persons of row 1 are going to face south and these 2 people sit opposite to each other. Okay. From people row 1 and row 2. Okay. In the same manner, row 3 people are going to face opposite to row 2 people. So that is why these are the 4 people who are facing north. So that is why I can certainly say that these are the 4 persons who are going to sit here and facing these people opposite to. Okay. So this is the basic concept. Alright. So we have to arrange all these things in this way. Okay, this is the seating arrangement. So we have to find out who is sitting where in this arrangement. Okay, So this is not so tough. You can make it very easily. Alright, let's try to solve it. I have taken only a few information here so that I can put all the possibilities together very easily. Right? So from on EE, I have taken the information to substitute in the next slide. Okay? As you can see, the first information is E faces the one who sits second to the right of P. So whoever is going to sit second to the right of P, so P second right person is going to face E here. So P second right person is going to face E here. So that's the first information which is given here. Alright. So but then it is going to make so many possibilities. So I'm just going to keep it on hold. Okay. The next one is no one sits to the left of E. So nobody is going to sit to the left of E. E's left portion is going to sit no one. Okay. So for that reason, E has to be at the extreme end. So if I am going to place E here, to the left of E, nobody is sitting. Okay. Because E is facing north, nobody is sitting to the left of E. Here again, we cannot able to place E here because to the left of E, there are three persons sitting. Okay. This is the first possibility. If I am going to place E here, to the left of E, nobody is sitting because E is facing south. Okay. So this is one more possibility. If I am going to place E here, to the left of E, nobody is sitting. So therefore, there is one more possibility as well. I cannot able to place E here because if I am going to place E here, to the left of E, there are three persons sitting. Okay. So here again, if I am going to place E here, E's left is this. So nobody is going to sit there. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four possibilities which we get out here. So that is why what I am going to do, I am just going to keep it on hold as I am having only maximum of three possibilities here. Okay. The next one is only one person sits between P and R. So between P and R, there is a gap of only one person. Okay. Between P and R, there is a gap of only one person. But then we don't know where P or R is. So that is why I am just going to keep it on hold. The next one is only two person sits between R and the one who faces F. So between R and the one who faces F. So R and this person. Okay, this person is going to face F. So between these two persons, R and this person, there is a gap of two persons. Right? So that is one more information, but then we are not sure how to put this information over here. Okay? Alright. Now, let's see what is the next thing is. D sits immediate right of F. So D is going to sit immediate right of F. F's immediate right is D. So, D sits immediate right of F. But then we don't know where F and D is. So, we cannot able to put this again. The next one is, D does not sit at any end of the row. So, D is not going to sit at any end of the row. Now, if we are going to put this information over and over and again, so we may not get the answer. So that is why what I'm going to do is I'm just going to I'll try to solve it. Okay, I'll try to substitute this information. For example, if I'm going to place E here, so E is is 1, 2, so P has to be here. Now see, P's second right has to be the person who is facing E. P's right is this, second right would be 1, 2. E is this person. Okay. Now E to the left of E, nobody is sitting. Of course, nobody is sitting. Between P and R, there is a gap of one person. We cannot go this way. We have to go this way. P one place, R has to be here. Okay. Now, between R and F, R and the one who facing F, between these two people, there is a gap of two persons. R is here, 1, 2. So, this person has to face F. Okay. R and this person has to face F. Okay. Now, what information can be done? F's immediate right has to be D because F is facing north. F's immediate right is this, so D has to be placed here. D has to be placed. Okay, so this is done, this is done, this is done. D is not sitting at the end, of course, D is not sitting at the end. Okay, now this is the first possibility. The second possibility is that if I am going to place E here, so E's opposite person is this, so 1, 2, P is here. Now see, P's second right person is going to face E. P is right is this, second right would be 1, 2. This person is facing E. Of course, this is correct. Now between P and R, there is a gap of 1%. P is here one place. We cannot go this way. P is here one place. R can be at this particular place. Okay. Now, R and the one who is facing F. So between these two people, there is a gap of 2%. So R is here 1, 2. So this person may face F. But then, if I am going to place F here, F's immediate right has to be D. So there is no immediate right of F because F is facing south. There is no immediate right. Therefore, I can certainly say that F cannot be here at this particular place. Now, between R and the one who is facing F, between these two people, there is a gap of 2%. We gone this way. Let us go this way. R is here 1, 2. So this person has to face F. Now see, F is immediate right is D. F is here. F is immediate right is this. So D has to be here. That's also done. Okay. Now see. So we already know that D cannot sit at the extreme end. But here D is sitting at the extreme end. So therefore this possibility gets eliminated at this particular point of time. So E cannot be at this place. So we have seen E here. E cannot be at this place. The next possibility is that. So E can be here. To the left of E, nobody is sitting. So another possibility is that. So E can be at this particular place. Okay. So to the left of E, nobody is sitting. So now P, one place, this person has to face P. So P is facing the one, P second right person is going to face E. Because P is facing south direction, P second right is 1, 2, E is here. Okay. Here again, 1, 2. So P has to be here. P second right person has to face E. Okay. So P is here, P second right is this, second right would be 1, 2, so E has to be at this particular place. So this is done. Now between P and R, there is a gap of 1%, P is here, 1 gap, R has to be here, so P is here, 1 gap, R has to be at this particular place. So this is done. So to the left of E, nobody is sitting, of course that's done. So now see, R and F, R and the person who is facing F, so between these two people, there is a gap of 2%. R is here, 1, 2, so this person has to face F, okay? So R is here, 1, 2, so this person has to face F. If I am going to place F here, F is immediate right is D, that is not possible. So therefore, F cannot be here, okay? R is here, 1, 2, so 1, 2, this person has to face F here, okay? So this is also done. F is immediate right is D, because F is facing south, F is right is this, immediate right is this, D has to be here. Okay. So see here, F is immediate right is this, F is facing south, F is immediate right is this, so D has to be at this particular place. Right. So see here friends, D should not sit at the extreme end, but in this possibility also, D is sitting at the extreme end. So therefore, this possibility again goes out. Okay. So this is done. Alright. So see, don't go by the length of the explanation. Because I am explaining, I need to explain it in a cool and calm way. That is why I am going to take much time. Okay. The next one is Q sits second to the right of the one who faces D. So the one who faces D, that person's second right has to be Q. So this person is facing D. So this person's second right. Right is this. Second right would be 1, 2. So Q has to be here. Okay. So D is here, D is facing this person, this person's right is this, second right would be 1, 2, so this person has to be Q here. Clear about this? Okay. The next one is A face the one who sits on the immediate left of Q. So A face the one who sits immediate left of Q. Q's immediate left is this person has to face A, so therefore A has to be here. So Q's immediate left is, so see here, A face the one who sits immediate left of Q. Q's immediate left is this. So, A has to be at this particular place. Q's immediate left is A. Okay. The next one is G faces S. So, G is going to face S. But does not sit at the end of the row. So, G and S are not going to sit at the extreme end. Because, it is very clearly mentioned that G is not going to sit at the extreme end. If G is not sitting at the extreme end, S will also not sitting at the extreme end. The next one is P is not the immediate neighbor of G. So P is not the immediate neighbor of G. Okay. So P cannot be an immediate neighbor to G here. Alright. Now can we able to substitute? So see here. So GRS cannot be at the extreme end. So GRS cannot be here. GRS can be here. So G, if I mean, G, because this place is filled, we cannot able to place anything. Because this field place is filled, we cannot able to place anything. We cannot able to place here, here, here. Okay. So G and S cannot be at the extreme end. So therefore, I can certainly say that G and S has to be only at this particular place. Okay. So P and G are not immediate neighbors. If P and G are not immediate neighbors, I can certainly say that G has to be here, S has to be at this particular place. Okay. Now see, we cannot able to place G or S here because they are not going to sit there at the extreme end. So Q is here. So therefore, we cannot able to place it here, here, or here. So we cannot able to fill this way, this also. So therefore, G is not an immediate neighbor to P. G cannot be here. So G has to be here. And S had to be at this particular place. Right? That's done, right? Let's check out the next information here. Only 1% sits between K and S. So between K and S, there's a gap of 1%. S is here, 1 plus K has to be here. So here S is here, 1 plus K has to be here. The next one is K faces the one who sits third to the right of N. So K faces the one who sits third to the right of N. So K faces this person. This person has to sit third to the right of N. Okay. 1, 2, 3. N has to be here. No, N's third right. 1, 2, 3. So K has to face this person. Okay. Now here K is here. K's third right has to be N. I mean this person has to be third to the right of N. 1, 2, 3. So N has to be here. So because N is facing south, N's right is this. So 1, 2, 3. So this person is going to face K. Okay, K faces the one who sits third to the right of N. N's third right has to face K. I'm sure you are clear about the concept. The next one is J and M are immediate neighbors. So J and M are immediate neighbors. So but then here J or M can be here, J or M can be here. So here J or M can be here, J or M can be here. The next one is J does not face D. So if J is not going to face D, I can certainly say that J has to be here. So M will face D here. Okay. Now here. So J is not going to face D here. Okay. So this is D, this is not P. Right? So J is not going to, see here, J does not face D, so therefore J cannot be here. If J cannot be here, J has to be here, so M has to be at this particular place. Clear? The next one is only 2% sits between M and L. So between M and L, there is a gap of only 2%. M is here, 1, 2, L is here. Okay? So here again, M is here, 1, 2, L has to be here. So only 2% sits between M and L. Of course, it's correct. The next one is more than 2% sits between B and C. More than means what? So more than 3 means what? So sorry, more than 2 means what? It has to be at least 3 or more between B and C. So between B and C. Okay. C who does not face L. C is not going to face L. So therefore, C cannot be here. C cannot be here, I can certainly say that B has to be here. All the places are filled, so C has to be here. Okay. So, that's done. So, C who does not face L, of course, C is not facing L. Okay. Now, here, between B and C, there should be at least 2 persons. Okay. So, C does not face L. So, if C cannot be here, I can certainly say that B has to be here, then C has to be at this particular place. The last information is C does not face south, but in this case C is facing south. That is totally wrong. Okay. So, it is the final arrangement, friends. Of course, it is a little tough one. If you don't practice these kind of questions, so you may fail difficulty to do everything in the actual exam. Right? So,